So we'll start off with basic cables. What is its purpose? Normally any electrical circuit, definitely it needs to have power supply, it needs to have some load device, could be in the form of some bulb, some resistor, and definitely we require some conductor to carry the current. So these are the three basic requirements for any current flow. We require some power source, some load, as well as for some sort of a conducting devices. Now whenever you need to opt for this specific type of cable, because the cable could be made of aluminium wire, it could be made of copper. So what specific type of cable we need to use, that depends on the ability to carry the specific load and its reliability under certain conditions. So you need to consider these two factors before you opt for the specific type of cable. So need to check for the load carrying capability and its reliability under certain condition. What exactly it means by its reliability under certain condition? It implies that if the environment is humid, in that case probably if I got some insulation which would react with humidity and make the insulator soft, we won't be using that specific type of cable. If the specific cable is not suitable for certain high temperature application and the insulator could burn, in that case definitely we won't be using that cable. It depends on the operating condition and the load carrying capability. So these two factors you need to keep in mind before you choose for the exact type of cable. Now regarding the material and all, we can have cables of different material. We also need to consider the flexibility, the insulation, and the diameter. The diameter is specified in terms of American wire gauge AWG, the length of wire, and the type of installation. Type of installation means again exactly the environment wherever we are putting this cable. So we need to consider the type of installation, the length of wire, because we know the resistance has got some effect on length. As we, if you recall, R equal to rho L by A, resistance is directly proportional to the length and inversely proportional to the area of cross section or the diameter, and that is the reason why you have mentioned length and diameter. So you route the cable through some area, and probably if the cable is not flexible enough, in that case the cable would break down. So you need to consider the flexibility factor as well, along with the conductivity, because different material would have different conductivity rates. So all these factors you need to take into account before you opt for the specific type of cable. Cable conductors, it can be made of copper, it can be made of aluminium. In certain places it could be made of stainless steel. Again, it's up to you and the place wherever you are installing the cable, as well as the economic feasibility. What we do to achieve the desired degree of flexibility, so we do this wire twisting. The individual strands are being twisted together, so that the sole purpose of doing this is to gain certain degree of flexibility. Insulating material, whenever we need to opt or choose the insulating material, we need to consider the fact that the insulation does not break down, because if it breaks down it can lead to short circuit. We need to consider the voltage, we need to consider the current, we need to consider the temperature, we need to consider whether the place wherever you are installing it is flexible or rigid, because certain places if it is flexible and if the material or the insulating material is not able to withstand that stresses imposed because of the flexing action, in that case the insulator would break down and it would lead to short circuit. So we need to consider the factor as well. So based on these factors, we can broadly categorize insulation, or we can have insulation of different materials. It could be of rubber, it could be of PVC, nylon, polyamide, or any type of fluoroelastomer. Out of this rubber type insulation, which definitely do not use nowadays, we use nylon, PVC, or polyamide. So these are the type of insulation we use nowadays, and we definitely do not use rubber. Some cables have insulation thickness up to 0.006 inches. The cable insulation is applied by extruding and warping. Next is carbon arc tracking. You need to keep in mind that if there is short circuit, it can lead to arc. And what possibly and how possibly we can have this arc? quite natural that the arc would be because of some insulation breakdown. Now, if the insulation breaks down and we are getting some arc, it could be because of two possibilities. Either it could happen on its own in some dry atmosphere or with some moisture in it. Now, if the arc happened to be in place in situation where the atmosphere is dry and there is no interference of humidity, that type of arc we call as dry arc tracking. And if it happens due to moisture, humidity, that is wet arc tracking. So that's how we basically categorize arc. But there is short circuit. So short circuit would result in some sudden increase in the current flow from the path of lowest resistance, quite natural. And this sudden increase in the current flow because of the short circuit would result in some fire. Now this fire can break down the insulation. And if the insulation breaks down, the insulation will burn and the byproducts will be carbon. Now this carbon in itself is conductive because we know carbon is conductive. And that is why in the battery and cells the central electrode is carbon, because it is conductive. So because carbon, we are getting carbon as the byproduct of this burn product, burn insulation, and this carbon in itself is conductive. So with the carbon formation, and if the carbon now get deposited and finally it try to mix together, and if there is any physical contact between this carbon and between this carbon, in that case again it is going to lead to further short circuit, and then the arc will prolong and there will be continuous arcing. You can have extremely high temperature in the range of 3000 degrees Celsius along with the emission of carbon monoxide, and this is known as flashover. So you need to remember the definition for flashover. Carbon arc tracking result in two primary effects, wet arc tracking and dry arc tracking. So you will get this tracking because of moisture. Dry arc without any moisture, and the insulation could break down because of some chapping action, because of some rubbing action, the insulation breaks down, and then they are in contact with each other, leading to a path of lowest resistance, current flow, high temperature, the insulation is again burning down, we are getting carbon then mating against each other, and thereby leading to further to a path of lowest resistance and further arcing. So this is dry arc tracking. So you can see here, this is cable, insulation breakdown, and then you have got the carbon deposits, and that leads to the short circuit. So you've got carbon deposits here, this carbon deposits here. So in between these individual cables, it is leading to short circuit. And finally, you can have this fire with the temperature can raise up to 3000 degrees Celsius. And we can have carbon monoxide as well. Cable sizing, it is specified in terms of AWG, as I told you before. And always remember, if the size is more, then if the number is more, size is lesser. Least the size, more will be the number. That means 000 will have the maximum size and 100 will have the lesser size. The size will be smaller. Next, electrical characteristics. The resistance of any conductor, it would depend on the type of conductor. Quite natural, different conductor will have different resistivity, because the resistivity, conductor, type of material are there, you know, we got a relation, because silver or gold or aluminium, this wood, titanium, all have different conductivity. So it depends on the conductivity of the material. It depends on the length and the area of cross section. Quite natural, that's what the basic equation of resistance says, that it must depends on the length as well as the area of cross section. And it would depend on the temperature as well, because the coefficient of resistivity depends on the temperature. Wherever large distance wiring is required, we will be using aluminium wire. Remember it, do not forget it. The aluminium cable smaller than 6 gauge is never used on aircraft. And if you need to substitute copper with aluminium, in that case, it should be 2 gauge larger. Whenever we consider the temperature withstand capability of cable, we need to consider two factors. We need to consider the normal ambient temperature, plus we need to consider the loss because of the eddy current as well, and or the copper loss or whatever you say. So basically it is the internal factors we need to consider as well as the external factor. External factor is the ambient temperature, and the internal factor loss is the I square R loss. In no case the I square R should be more than 40 degrees Celsius. Remember it. So cables come in three forms: airframe cables, interconnect cables, and equipment cables. Airframe cables are used for open wiring in airframe and engine. Another name for it is medium weight interconnect. Then we have got the interconnect cables, where if I need to put cables to join two adjacent part of a structure together, in that case we use interconnect cables. Another name for it is lightweight interconnect, and we need to ensure that wherever we are installing it, it should not have any pulling action. No pulling action. We need to keep in mind. What is the difference between interconnect and airframe cable? The difference lies in the thickness of the insulation. In case of interconnect cable, the thickness of the insulation is lesser. Why we need it? In order to increase the flexibility, save weight and space. Equipment wire is used inside the equipment, inside the instruments. What type of wire is suitable for soldering? Equipment wire. What is another name for it? Module wire. So these are the things you need to keep in mind. Now, cable type based on the construction. You can see here we have got a single core, as the name suggests, only one core. Multi-core, more than one. Screen type, this is the screen. This is the screen. Database cable used in the avionics equipments. Coaxial cable, one cable, another cable, and sharing the same axis, so coaxial. High tension cable, the one that I told you about, the stainless steel wire, so those are high tension. Normal thermocouple. Fire resistance and fireproof. Certain cables which are resistant to fire, or some of the cables will be fireproof. Even if you put fire, it won't burn. So these are the different types of cables, and you need to know few things about these cables. Single core, you can see here, coated copper conductor. Dual wall extruded, single wall wrapped insulation. If it is plain, it is dual wall extruded type. If it is, you can see some marking, hash type marking, so that is single wall wrapped insulation. Remember this difference. Airframe and interconnect cables are supplied in multi-core form and generally up to four. Remember. Outer insulation, another name for it is sheath. Remember, you have got individual insulated, and then again outer portion is also insulated. Screen type. Now if I require the cables to withstand the any type of interference because of the change in the current flow, because any change in current flow would lead to change in the magnetic flux, and that change in magnetic flux would lead to any type of interference with the cable, and if this cable is part of some electrical, radio, avionics equipment, the equipment could get wrong reading. So we need to take care of this and use some cable which can or which would not have any type of interference effect, and for that we are using this screen type. So as the name suggests, screen, so it is screening those sort of problem. So you have got tin copper conductor. Tin copper means it is made of copper, and then the initial coating is of tin in order to provide anti-resistant anti-corrosion treatment. We have got the inner insulation, the outer part, outer insulator, and in between we have got this braided shield or this screen. So it is the screen portion which is filtering out or preventing any type of magnetic or electromagnetic interference. Yeah. What is the advantage of twisting it? Because if you twist it, because we know this electromagnetic radiations, it flow in the sinusoidal pattern, and in order to prevent any type of interference and make sure that the interference does not happen, we want destructive interference, and for that it is possible that they become out of phase. And to ensure that they become out of phase, one of the possible and easiest way is twist it. So twisting is done in order to prevent any type of interference.